Hi and welcome. Network access or admission control or NAC basically prevents an internal network of an organization from access by malicious endpoints over wired or wireless media. And in this video, I will give an overview of network access control, including the background of this technology. Now in 1990s, the main focus of network security was on perimeter defense. For example, deploying the firewalls at the perimeter of an organization. Then in 2000, recognizing that this perimeter defense alone was insufficient, the concept of defense in depth or layer defense became popular. Then in around 2010, the concept of continuum monitoring emerged in the form of security information and event management or SIEM solutions, and the purpose was to detect the intruder if this layered defense is bypassed. Nowadays, the advanced persistent threat are compromising an organization by physically bypassing the technical parametric controls and sometimes using the legitimate user to connect to the internal networks. Therefore, the concept of active defense is evolving to proactively protect the organization, including securing access to internal networks using the network access control. Now, this network access control basically prevents an internal network of an organization from access by malicious endpoints over wired or wireless media. And 802.1x is an IEEE standard, which is basically a port-based network access control. And it has basically three components. Now this 802.1x is a basic form of network access control, and its components include a supplicant, authenticator, and authentication server. Now this supplicant is basically an endpoint for a user, and this authenticator is switch or wireless access point, and this authentication server is any server, for example, remote authentication, dial-in user service, a server or a radius. So basically, before granting access to a supplicant, the authenticator gets this supplicant verified from this authentication server. So after this it is verified, then the supplicant or the endpoint is granted access to the internal network. So not only this supplicant is verified by the authenticator, but also the authenticator is also verified by the supplicant to counter man-in-the-middle attack, for example, which is launched by using a rogue access point by the hacker. Now this 802.1x has certain compatibility issues. For example, the endpoints were normally not compliant with this 802.1x, and one of the example includes an agentless endpoint which is authenticated by using its MAC address only over the 802.1x. So if this MAC address is being forged or being spoofed by the hacker, then there was no protection. Now this NAC checks the not only the user, but also it checks the detailed security posture of the endpoints besides its MAC address. So it is a more comprehensive solution as comparison to 802.1x. So it also implements the 802.1x, but it also implements other features as well, which checks the security posture of the endpoint device. Now this bring your own device concept was evolved due to the proliferation of mobile devices, and now the modern NAC solution includes the endpoint security, for example, the vulnerability assessment of the endpoint, and then its update of its antivirus and checking the state of its services which are running over it and whether these services are patched. And it also includes the user or system authentication and then the network security. Now the NAT traffic may be encrypted using the extensible authentication protocol, transport layer security, or EAP TLS. Now EAP is basically a framework for authentication, and it has various variation, and one of the variation is transport layer security or TLS. Now this TLS basically requires a digital certificate by the endpoints or by the user using its smart card. So this certificate is either embedded into the smart card or it is either embedded into the endpoint device. Now the client of NAC may be agent or agentless, or this client may get installed on the fly once the endpoint is being connected to the network or before it is granting access to the network. So this NAC should support multiple operating systems, for example Windows, Mac and Linux, and multiple devices, for example printer, scanner and IP phones. And then the pre-admission control is basically a form of control before an endpoint is granting access to the device. So this pre-admission control includes the quarantining of these non-compliant endpoints and then fixing these endpoints by installing patches or antivirus updates, and then performing the vulnerability scanning, for example using the agentless NAC of the endpoint to check the vulnerable services running on the endpoints in order to patch these services, or if these services are launched by the hacker. Then there is a concept of captive portal, which basically intercept the web traffic of an endpoint, and it redirects to a portal or a website where the user has to put in the credentials in order to get it authenticated. Or user is also redirected to download the NAC tools or the patch or the antivirus software, antivirus updates. So there is another concept of VLAN assignment, where these endpoints are assigned VLANs of update or patch server only before granting access to the network. So these non-compliant but legitimate endpoints have to first install these updates from this update server, and after they are granting access to the granted access to the internal network. And one weak form of this pre-admission control is restricting this is not the MAC, this is the ARP and network discovery protocol, that is the IPv6 protocol, and this ARP is used on IPv4 protocol, that is address resolution protocol. So there is also a context-based access, that is depend upon the time of the day and the location of the endpoint and the type of the endpoint, whether it is a scanner or a laptop or a printer, and then the user role who is connecting through this endpoint. So based upon the context, the user is granted access to the internal network or the resources of an organization. So this there is also a post-admission control. Now after a user or an endpoint is granted access to the network of an organization, then this post-admission control requires to continue monitor this endpoint for any non-compliant behavior. And this is done by integrating this endpoint over the network operating center or NOC and the security operation center, that is the SOC. So now here is the list of these different NAC products by different vendors, and on the right side you can see the ranking by Gartner. So these products are basically open source products. And one is the OpenNAC, then PacketFence, and then this FreeNAC. And against these two products, there is no rating, and I have discovered it while browsing over the internet. So this was all from my side. This is my channel, and I put in all the links in the description. Please stay connected to my channel for similar videos. Thank you.